Hey guys, we are in the basement and today we're gonna do part number two of the 720 restoration. Now, if you guys remember in part number one, a couple of videos ago, we did a quick down and dirty restore of the 720 and we got it down here. However, we're not done. We got more stuff to address, namely the artwork, and that's what we're gonna do in this video. Now, first things first, look up here. We've got this horrible reproduction boombox overlay. Originally, it had two layers, this boombox, and one of the layers was die cut to only light up the 720 logo and this cassette right here. Okay, so someone put a really bad repro on there and we get like this hourglass shape. And I hate it, it's driving me nuts because it's not supposed to look like that. It looks very just sloppy and not right. So we're gonna replace this with the proper reproduction from Phoenix Arcade and the proper one that Phoenix has the correct two layers where only the 720 logo and the cassette player lights up. And then we're gonna also replace the overlay down here, the control panel overlay, because this one is garbage. So we're gonna strip it, we're gonna paint it, we're gonna prep it, we're gonna get it ready, and then we're gonna put the new overlays on. So first things first though, we gotta get this stuff off. So I'm gonna come up here and just kind of unscrew the boombox, and it shouldn't be a big deal to get off. It's just like six screws. So let's come up here and get this thing off, and you know what? I'm gonna be so much happier when this crap overlay is off. And so we've got some security screws here. They're the square type. And let's go ahead and get a square bit, and let's get this stuff off. So yeah, I've been loving the 720. I gotta say, I'm not getting better at it though. I've been playing it a lot. I suck at it, man. It's just, you know, it's a weird game where you gotta kind of really understand the skating mechanic, because it's very clumsy. Because if you don't land correctly, the guy falls. And when he falls, it's frustrating because he just sits there on the ground. So, whatever. Oh, I just dropped that. So let's get this off. It's gonna look so much better with the correct overlay on here. And I think that this is a digital print. And I think that someone cut out the circles. I can kind of see the jaggedness of it. Like it wasn't die cut. It looks like someone cut it out with an X-Acto blade. So this is just not a very good reproduction. And by the way, I am totally digging the new layout of the arcade. The 720 right here, this is the right spot. And if you guys missed it in the last video, I moved Burger Time right here next to it. And then I switched Burger Time and 720 essentially with Asteroids Deluxe and Breakout, put them over there. And it really made for an awesome corner. So I'm pretty thrilled. And then also the 720 kind of opened up the basement a little bit because the cabinet is sitting back. So you can now see over there a little easier. So pretty cool. All right, let's get the rest of these screws off. And let's see. So for that top, those top ones there, it's kind of tight. Let's see if we can just use only the bit and see if we can unscrew the top by hand. Because we're the duck here. It's kind of tight. I can't get the cordless screwdriver in there. I guess I could move the game out. Boy, that's really in there. I was hoping I didn't have to move the game. This game is a beast. All right, you know what? I'm gonna have to. Let me pull the game out just a little bit. Actually, you know what? I got them out. So there's one more here, but I can get it off by hand. I started moving the game, and man, is it heavy. I don't wanna move it. Let's just keep it where it is. All right, so we got all the screws off, and this thing just falls off just like so. And okay, so let's grab the control panel now. And I'm gonna come in the coin door and unlatch it. And we should have two latches, one here and one here. Okay. And now we should be able to lift this up. And there's one in, is there one in the center? No. Okay, so that's, all right, so now the control panel's off. And we need to unplug the Molex, like so. Okay. So we have the control panel off, we've got the boom box off, And let's go to the garage. Actually, you know what? I need to get some stripper and some paint. Do you guys want to go to the hardware store? You want to go with me? All right, let's get in the car. Let's take a ride over to the hardware store and let's get some stripper and paint and then go to the garage. All right. Okay, let's go back here to the paint section. And so I want to get a white paint for the control panel because I think the artwork will really pop. So let's get this semi-gloss enamel white. And then we need some stripper. And I'm going to get this stripper, which we used last time. This stuff was awesome. Premium stripper. Oh, they sell it in a big bottle, too. All right, and I think I have some black at home we can use for the boombox. All right. Let's go back to the basement. I love this place. And we're back from the hardware store. Now let's get to work. I actually came in here earlier and started the heater. It's in the 30s, it's like 32 degrees outside and feels good in here. So all right, let's get to work. I got the parts out here. I'm actually not looking forward to this, I have to admit, but I gotta do it, and I better do it before it gets way too cold, because I gotta do this in the garage, really. So, okay, first things first, we need to get the old artwork off of this stuff, and we're gonna use a combination of strippers, liquid stripper that we bought in the can at the hardware store, and maybe the heat gun. We'll see how it goes. So this one here, the boombox, I think the old overlay is gonna come off pretty easily. Let's just see. I mean, look at that, it's barely on here. Actually, we gotta pop it off of this. Oh man. So we've got, see, this overlay has this piece of acrylic behind it, and this piece of acrylic is stuck to it. All right. Now we're gonna have to try to figure out a way to clean this up and get this glue off of here without ruining this plastic. Boy, that's gonna be tough, man. All right, so the acrylic's off. And we also have an issue here with the speaker grill. Looks like someone soldered it on. We might try to do that too. Maybe we could fix it by soldering that. Kind of like a pseudo weld. And it looks like someone painted this thing silver. My guess. All right. Yeah, this is a crappy overlay. Look at that. Junk. Okay. All right, so that's that. Now we're gonna have to strip all this glue off of here and also figure out a way to clean this. Because I'm worried that all this glue that's on here, the light is gonna kind of show it. So we gotta do our best to clean this up without eating up the acrylic. All right, let's put that to the side. Let's put this down here. Okay, so now we need to remove all the buttons and the joysticks on here, which sucks, because we just put them on. Okay, I actually turned the heater off too. Much better. So let's get all these old buttons off. And I'm just gonna come in here with some needle-nose pliers and loosen the pal nuts. Okay, just kind of break them all. And again, these are leaf style switches. And we just got to do that. Let's pop this off, that off. Okay, we got all our buttons off. So put those to the side. All right, so now we can get this joystick off. And I remember this was a real pain in the butt to get on. Let me grab my cordless screwdriver here in a bit. Okay, I grabbed my cordless screwdriver with a standard bit. Now these screws on the front are not original. These were originally like carriage bolts. And I'm probably gonna go to the hardware store later when it's time to rebuild the joystick and try to find some carriage bolts that are like this. But we'll take advantage of the fact that these are standard screws because we can come in from the top with our corded screwdriver and get the nuts off pretty easily. The nuts are actually in a really tough spot. All right, so there's two. here. Let's get this 3. It's funny, look, I'm looking at this picture and the guy's skateboard, it's so gigantic. Boards back then were giant compared to what the kids are riding today. You know, everyone's riding like 7.5 inch, 7 inch dead wide decks. And back then everything was like 9 inches wide, 8.5. The deck I bought recently was an 8.5 inch kind of old school, which is good for vert. Because most of the kids today are doing street stuff and they use really narrow skateboards. Small, really small compared to what we rode in the 80s. Okay, all right, so that's that. Now the joystick should come right off. Now there is a ground wire right here with some kind of clip. Let's see if we can pull that off. Okay, and then we've got a zip strip here that's holding that on. Let me get some side cutters. And we're gonna carefully come in here, cut the zip strip and not the wires. Okay, so the joystick's off. And the buttons are off, and now we're ready to get this damn overlay off. So I'm gonna try to get it off without heat first and see how it goes. Where's my scraper? Right here, okay. All right, so, yeah, I think we're gonna need heat. Boy, this is really on there. Okay, let me plug in the heat gun, and we're gonna go to town on it. Okay, I'm just gonna heat this up. This is a pretty good looking overlay. I don't know if this is original or what. If it is, it's in pretty good shape. Except for the bottom edge here. So we're gonna heat this up and see if we can come in with our scraper. I'm tempted to spray that stripper on here right now and see what happens. Should we do that? Yeah, let's do that. I wonder if it'll eat up this overlay. Actually, that kind of worked. All right, let me get the stripper we bought at the hardware store. And this stuff is dangerous, man. Make sure you cover your eyes. Don't get this on your hands. But I'm going to put it on here. And I'm reading the can here. Blah, blah, blah. I'm trying to see how long it says to let it sit. Allow time for remover to work. Do not rush the job. Okay. Well, let's just... All right, I'm standing back and I'm watching my eyes. I wonder if this stuff will eat through the overlay. If not, we're going to have a big mess on our hands. Okay, let me get my tools out of the way. So again, this stuff's called Clean Strip Premium Stripper. We got this at Tractor Supply, which is a great little store. It's got everything in there. When I lived in Illinois, I used to go to Farm and Fleet. It's kind of like that, in Fleet Farm. All right. I do recommend wearing eye protection and gloves with this stuff, because this stuff will eat your skin. All right, I'm gonna let that sit for about 5 minutes, maybe 10. Yeah, let's go 10 or 15, and I'll be back. Okay, it's been about a half hour here, and look at this stripper did to this thing, man. Holy cow. It like wrinkled the whole thing up. Look at that. Man, that's some effective stuff. So I'm guessing it's just gonna fall off. And if it does, man, I'm never gonna mess around with a scraper and heat again. But I gotta be careful here because this stuff is gonna eat my hands. And I don't have any rubber gloves, and I know I should. And you gotta watch your eyes too with this crap. I'm gonna be very, very careful here, and I don't wanna touch this. But let's see what happens here. Oh yeah. Look at that. So it looks like we've got some layers going on here. I don't know if this was painted. Or it looks like someone might have painted this white. Look at that. It just falls off. Unbelievable. But we're left with kind of a mess here. Oh, man. So I might have to spray it again to get the rest of this off. Boy, this is a real mess here. All right, so let's... So I'm trying to do this in a way where I'm not touching this. I don't know if what I'm looking at here, this white, is paint. Did someone paint this white? I don't know. All right, let's turn it over. All right. It's pretty amazing how it just is falling off in one piece. This stuff absolutely rocks. Okay, so there's the old overlay. Look at that. Blech. Okay, I'm thinking I'm gonna spray this now and we'll get this next layer off, which I'm not sure if it's paint or what. All right, yeah, let's do that. Let's spray this next layer and then let this sit for a half hour or so. Hope I don't run out of this stuff because I gotta do the boombox too. We gotta get all that adhesive off. But this is a big mess here, man. I mean, I hope we can clean all this off because this is a gigantic mess. All right, so let's let this next layer soak in this stripper. I think I'm gonna go a half hour again. Let's let it do its job. Okay, all right, I'll be right back. So it's about 10 to 6 right now, so we'll come back around 6:15. Okay, it's been a half hour here. Now let's see what happens. Again, I don't wanna touch this stuff. Oh yeah. So it looks like we're getting the rest of it off. And taking some of that paint off too, which is good. Ugh. I hate doing this. It's such a pain in the ass to prep this stuff. I need to start going to a powder coater. Just drop this shit off and say, here, do it. Because they'll sandblast it, they'll powder coat it. I don't have to do any of this stuff. God, this is a mess. So it looks like this was painted black. I think we're gonna paint it white. We bought that white paint at the hardware store. You know, the artwork on 720, the overlay's got a lot of white in it. The black and white checker pattern. And I think the white paint will really help that white pop. All right, well, we got most of it off. Shit. Making a gigantic mess here. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna clean all this stuff up. I'm gonna get some paper towel and Simple Green and just clean this whole area up. And then we'll kind of assess what's going on here. There's still a lot of adhesive on this. I'm wondering if we could sand this now. Yeah, all right, I'm gonna clean this up and then I'll be right back. Okay, I cleaned it all up with some Simple Green and cleaned the garbage can up, which is my workbench right now. So I'm going to hit this thing with some 80 grit sandpaper with my quarter sheet sander. And we're just going to try to get all this junk off of here. It's still a little bit wet. I'm out of paper towels. Urgh. I go through so many paper towels in the garage, you would not believe. Like rolls and rolls and rolls of them. Anyway, all right, so we're going to hit it with this 80 grit. I'm going to go get some paper towels here. And actually, you know what? This is one of those segments where I fast forward and I play music, right? You know, usually in my videos, you know, I do some work and then we stop and then music plays and then it goes real fast and the music's playing most of the music, if not all the music, except for a few canned little things, I've actually done myself, or me and my band, the Kill Screens. Music recorded in the basement. So, you know what? We need a song right now, because we're gonna fast forward through here with the sander. We need music. And you know what? We need a good song for this sanding little montage. So you know what? Maybe we should go in the basement real quick. You want to record a song that we can play during this sanding part? That'd be kind of cool, right? All right, let's go in the basement and quickly record a song, and then we'll come back out here, and then we'll play the song and sand. All right, let's go to the basement. All right, guys, we're going to record a really fast song for this segment, and we're going to do it quick and in real time, and I thought it'd be fun. Why not? So, okay, I'm in Pro Tools here. And I'm just going to create a blank session. And I think the first thing we're going to do is we're going to make a beat. And hopefully you guys enjoy this. I don't know. I thought it'd be fun. Why not? So let's create a blank session. And let's just call it 720 segment. Which I had that there. All right. So, all right. Let's get... I'm going to do this fast. So we're going to get a drum loop. Sometimes I use loops and screw with them. Sometimes I make my own beats. I think for now we're gonna just grab a beat. Let's see if I can just find something. Up-tempo rock, why not? Let's try that. Let's see now. Let's see. I'm trying to find something that's kind of cool. See what else we got here. Rock grooves. Let's see what we got. So do we want to do like a guitar song? Guitar and synth maybe? Is that too slow? Just want something simple here. That might work. Let's try that. And we'll import the tempo. So now our session is at 125 BPM. Let's go ahead here. What do you think of that? Is that all right? Yeah, I think that can work. All right, so maybe we'll screw with it a little bit, make it cooler. Maybe we'll just go like this and see how that sounds. Kind of duplicate that snare there. Kind of kill screen it up a little bit. Yeah, why not? Let's do that. So let's duplicate this a whole bunch of times. Trying to go as fast as I can here. Let's put a little compression on it. I'm on the top monitor. You guys can't see that, but. So let's fatten it up. Maybe we'll throw a little distortion on it. And we'll use this. Thank you. I think that's okay for now. All right, so maybe we'll throw some hats on here. Let's see, what's this? Let's just use that. I'll throw that in here. Let's do some 16th note hats. Duplicate it a whole bunch of times. Kind of trying to find like some cool EQ on the hat here. Come on, loop. Loop playback. That's kind of cool. So let's duplicate that. Like that? All right, let's quickly add a new track. I want to do a stereo aux track, and I'm going to throw a reverb on it just so I can send a little bit of the hats to my aux channel. So we'll do input 3-4, bus. Input bus. What's going on here? Alright, so auxiliary, input bus, reverb, output, bus, reverb. Okay, so now. Kind of cool, and I'll send a little bit of the drums into the reverb channel. All right, so now we got a beat going. So let's throw down some really quick guitar here, and I'm just gonna make something up here really quick. I should be all tuned up. And we're just gonna use my little Pro Junior amp down here. I've got other way better amps, but that's a great little tube amp. And I use it in the studio here all the time because it's small and doesn't take up a lot of room. But I've got some other stuff, but it'll be good enough for this. So I guess we'll just use my trusty Strat amp. So it should be in tune. Let me get that. Stupid. All right. All right, let's play along with this and see if we can come up with something really fast. You know what? That's good enough. We're doing this quick. All right, I'm gonna come over here and add a track. Mono audio track, we're gonna record through that. Get some levels. And I'm gonna do this with bleed. Normally I do this with headphones. Alright, let me turn the input on the mic down just a hair. Alright. Alright, that's cool. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna record right now. Ready? Hang on. I feel like I'm off there. Thank you. let's see how that sounds. And so we got this guitar off. All right, we're going quick here. I know this is not the Pro Tools channel. All right, so let's come in here and see how our guitar sounds. So we're right here. Okay. So. All right, that sounds okay. Let me just loop this a few times and just kind of tune up my guitar. I think that's kind of cool, right? All right, so I'm gonna kind of duplicate it here. So we got that. You like it? You digging it? I'm down with it. All right, so now I'm going to add another track. Stupid synth. I didn't mean to open this one and it's off the window. Crap. Dang it, we're gonna have to quit this. Damn it. I hope I didn't lose that. I don't think I did. So, are we having fun making a song? All right, so we got the guitar, we got the drums. I want to add some kind of synth. And then that's gonna be it. I need to go into that session folder, audio disc 720 segment, session file backups. Here we go. So which one is newer? This one. Hopefully it saved that. So I'm loading the backup because that thing crashed. All right, good. My guitar's still there. All right, so let's try this again. We're gonna add a new instrument, stereo instrument track, and we're gonna use multi-channel plug-in instrument. Let's try, we'll use expand, why not? All right, so we have expand here. And it's not playing though. All right, let's get a cool sound here. What do you want to do, a pad? Something appreciated? Let's try this. That's kind of cool. Again, let's hear our sound. Thank you. Why don't we roll with that? All right, that's kind of cool. All right, I just dropped my mouse. And so I'm gonna throw this in there. Let's come over here. I'll just, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit record on that track. And we'll just throw that guy down. Now this isn't a pregiator, so if you're kind of cheating. Just hold it in, all right? Song. Should we throw down another instrument? What do you think? Let's listen to it. Actually, let's quantize this a little bit. Options, audio, blah blah, event, MIDI, real time, quantize, eighth note. Hang on, let's see. It's coming in MIDI, quantize. Come on, move. Quantize to the eighth note. Quantize means it's gonna suck everything to the grid, so it's in time. This is MIDI. I'm adding some more voices here. Let's hear how it sounds. What do you think? Good enough? All right, we're done. There's our music for this segment. Let's go back to the garage. I think that'll work. All right, we're back. So we got our song. And now we can sand. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start it and see how it goes. And now here's the part where we fast forward it, so let's play our song that we just recorded. Guys, it's all sanded and it's absolutely great, actually. It's all ready now for painting. I'm gonna go ahead though and clean it up with some simple green. I want to get all this sanding dust off here. You definitely don't want to paint on the sanding dust, so let's just clean it up real well. and then we'll move on to the boombox. We gotta clean that thing up too. And I'm debating if I want to paint this whole thing white. I think I'm going to, because I definitely want to paint the front white, because I really think the colors are gonna pop if I do. And I'm not really worried how this looks, because you're not gonna see it. But we want to just put a nice coat of paint on this, just to protect it, so it doesn't rust underneath the overlay. So all right, that's ready. So let's move on to the boombox. Whoops. All right, so the boombox has an issue here that we need to address before we paint or anything. You see this grill? It's broken. And it looked like someone tried to solder it on, and maybe it did fix it, but their solder joint broke. So we're gonna try to solder it too. So I'm gonna come in here and just sand this off so we got some bare metal. And hopefully this will work. I mean, it's gonna require a lot of heat to solder this, but it looks like somebody else was successful, so maybe we can be too. I'm just coming in here by hand with some 80 grit. My propane tank is running out. It's almost done. I may have to run to the store and get some more propane. It's cold out there, man. I cannot paint this stuff in the garage in this weather. I want this stuff to really dry nice, so that tomorrow it's like thoroughly cured and we can put the overlay on both of these pieces. Okay, so it looks like we could solder here and over here. We can remove some more. Yeah, my propane tank's about to run out. I hear the heater is getting quieter and quieter over there. I've already gone through two tanks since I got that thing, but it has been an absolute lifesaver. Okay, so we got two nice areas. I'm gonna go ahead and plug our soldering iron in and we'll solder that. Okay, so our soldering iron is all hot here, and we're gonna attempt to solder and tack the speaker grill here and here, and I hope this works. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Maybe get some JB Weld. So I'm gonna put some flux on here to kind of help us out with the, just kind of keeping it clean and evenly dispersing the heat. And it's going to require a lot of heat to get this to hold, but we'll see what happens. I'm kind of putting liberal amounts of flux on here. Okay, so let's see what happens. And we'll keep our screwdriver close by because we're going to need that to hold it down. So let me put some pressure on this and let's see what happens here. And like I said, hopefully we can get this hot enough that the part takes the solder. Let me think about this. Okay, I'm back. I went to the hardware store because the soldering was just a failed experiment. And I picked up some of this steel weld. I think it's just like JB Weld. And I'm going to sand this real quick. Probably should clean the flux off of here first. Duh. So this better work, man, because if it doesn't, I'm hosed. I think it will, though. It says this steel weld stuff, it sets in 4 minutes, which is great. All right. Got all kinds of junk in these holes. It's just flux, okay? All right. Let me come back in here with my sander. Just want to... Okay, I just wanted to sand a nice area that we can use that adhesive, so we're gonna use it like right here and here. All right, let's get it and let's see how it works. So I've never used this brand, but I think it's very similar, if not the same as JB Weld. Let's read the instructions. For best results, roughen, remove any grease and oil, clean and dry surfaces, blah, 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 remove plastic. Mixing paddle from center of black plunger. Remove plastic mixing paddle from center of black plunger. Oh, this thing here. Okay. Oh, that's the mixer. Huh, interesting. Okay, so there's a little thing in the middle here. So this is our mixer. Okay, so this is our mixer, I guess, okay? Let's see, remove, push plunger, remove, allow air, turn nozzle end up and pull plunger back slightly. Turn nozzle end up and pull plunger back slightly, okay? Okay. Allow air bubbles to rise to the top, snap off, and save the storage cap. Okay, so we're gonna save this. We're learning as we go here, kids. Push plunger evenly to dispense equal amounts of hardener and resin onto a discardable surface. Mix thoroughly with paddle provided. Apply to surfaces to be joined or repaired. Epoxy starts to set in 4 minutes. All right. You know, before I do this, I need something to put on this. We need a weight. Is this good enough? Nope, not heavy enough. Let me find something heavy to put on here. All right, I threw some paint cans on here. So let's go ahead and squirt some of this in here. Okay, I'm sure that's plenty. Let's get our little mixer. stuff reeks. This better work, man. I'm wondering if I should put a washer or something on there. Let's see what happens. All right, so I want to use this kind of sparingly. So let's come in here. Just put it along this seam. Okay. Put it there. Okay. All right, so I think that's going to do it. I'll put a little bit more here. Maybe some back here. I don't know if you guys can see what's going on here, but hopefully this works. All right, so we're gonna let this dry and we'll be back. So let's let it sit for, 10 minutes or so before we take the cans off. It says it sets in 4, so we'll be back. All right, guys, it's actually the next day here. I let this stuff dry overnight and I put a whole bunch of paint cans on here. And hopefully it's all fixed. So let's see what's going on. And it is. Perfect. So that worked out pretty well. It's ugly as sin, but it works. Now it looks like we got some on the other side here. Huh. All right, I think I'm gonna sand this down and then we might take a drill maybe and just poke holes back through it, through that stuff. Let's see. Yeah, it's on there pretty good. But I'm gonna sand all this down. I'm wondering if I should use some stripper on this side to get the adhesive off. Yeah, I think we will. Let's spray this side with the stripper real quick. Actually, let me clean up the paint cans here. Okay, I'm just gonna hit this side with that stripper. I got a little bit left in here. And let's see if we can get all this adhesive off. And then we'll sand this all down. I don't have much left here. Come on, give me more. Damn it. Well, looks like that's gonna have to do. So I'm gonna let that sit for about 10-20 minutes and we'll be back. All right, this has been soaking for about 15 minutes. I actually put this other stuff on here too. I had lift-off spray paint. All right, let's see what happens. We can get all this crap off. And looks like we can. That's good. I don't know if there's like silver paint on here or what. This is a very messy process. So I was looking at that white paint that I bought it at the hardware store, Tractor Supply, and it talks about needing a primer. So I think I'm gonna go back out in a little bit and get a different kind of spray paint. It's the morning here and Ace Hardware's open, so I'll probably go there and see what they have. But we gotta get this cleaned up first. And also on Craigslist, someone posted 4 Nintendo monitors for free. Sanyo 20 EZs. And the guy said in the listing, if this listing's still up, I still have them. So I immediately messaged him and said, I will come get them. So we might have that little distraction today, because I'm gonna go grab those, assuming it's not too much of a drive. Can never have too many Nintendo monitors, right? Alright, so I guess that's gonna be about as good as I get in here. And then we'll hopefully sand the rest off. I'm gonna go ahead and clean this up. And then we'll get our sander out and go to town on this thing. And then we've got some adhesive back here too, that I think I could probably just sand this off. We'll see. We do have to be careful of our work over here. All right, let me clean this up and we'll be right back. All right, I cleaned it up here and there's still a lot of gooey residue on here. So I ran out to Ace Hardware and, well, Tractor Supply was out of that stripper. So I bought some goof off. This stuff usually works pretty well. I need to get all this glue off though. This is not good. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put some of this all over here. It's gonna be a little sloppy about it. This stuff's usually pretty good. There's goof off and there's goo gone. So this is goof off. Goof off is definitely more strong. It's the stronger of the two. This stuff will like eat through plastic and stuff, so you gotta be careful with it. It's relatively safe on your hands. I don't know, but I'd still be careful. All right, I'm just gonna let this soak here, and then we'll come back and see if we can get all this goo off. All right, be right back. Okay, I'm just kind of coming through here with my scraper, and I'm getting most of this off. I'm just putting some of this on a paper towel and just kind of wiping the area and then using the scraper to get the glue off. And it's actually working. I think all I have now is mostly paint on here. Boy, this thing's a mess. I question if whoever put the overlay on before that repro even went through this. I bet you the adhesive on here is a combination of the new and the original. And this looks like black paint. So, anyway, I'm gonna just keep going through it like this, taking my paper towel. Then just come through with the scraper and try to pick the adhesive up. Seems to be working pretty well. Then after this, I'm gonna sand it before we paint. All right, I'm gonna keep going. Be back. All right, I got all this crap off for the most part. Still a little gummy up here. I actually used that whole can of goof off. I had a little mishap here, guys. Look at this. You know, and while I was manhandling it, I undid my work here with that liquid, whatever that stuff was called, the steel meld or weld. So I'm gonna sand this and I'm gonna redo this. I was thinking the whole time, I should have done this after I sanded, because I really was manhandling this. So anyway, whatever, we'll redo it. So I'm gonna go ahead now and sand this whole thing down. And why don't we go ahead and play our new sanding song too, that we recorded earlier. So, all right, here we go. We'll be right back. Okay, I'm all sanded, I'm all smooth, there's no sticky residue. It's ready to be painted. I gotta tell you, that sucked. It was a lot of work. A lot of work. So I'm gonna repair this again. And I'm just gonna do it the same way I did it the first time. Look at that. I can actually pop it into place and it'll stay there. Huh. I'm gonna go ahead now and just put a little bit more of that steel weld stuff on here and then let it dry. So I'm just gonna do that myself. I'll do it the same exact way I did it last time. And looks pretty good right there. It's a little high. So it's supposed to be, I think, flush with this. All right, anyway, I'm gonna go glue this real quick and I'll be right back. Okay, I glued that again. Let me show you what I did. I actually threw some washers in there this time. I glued washers to it, and I think that's gonna help my cause here. Instead of just relying on the glue itself to hold the joint, I basically glued washers across the joint there, and I think that's gonna probably do it, so. All right, we're gonna let this dry for a few hours, and for now, though, I think I'm gonna come over here and hit this control panel with some white. Where is the white paint? Here it is. So I went to Ace and I picked up some of this 2x paint and primer. Should we do a white or black? I guess white's fine. I mean, this was originally black, but I kind of want the overlay because it's got a lot of white in it to kind of pop. So I thought it'd be really nice with white behind it. So we're gonna use white. And I'm gonna paint the back first. So let me shake this up really well. You know, this is taking forever. Honestly, I've been working on this for 2 days now, this stupid little project, and really, all the time has been spent cleaning metal parts. Not exactly fun. Oh, great. That boombox piece of metal was a nightmare, man. I mean, we also have to take care of that piece of plexi as well. All right. So let's come in here and hit this. And we'll do a couple coats both sides. Alright, we'll let that dry, and then I'll come back and hit, do a second coat in a little bit. Okay, I just put a second coat on the front, so we're pretty much done with the control panel. I'm gonna let it dry overnight. And now I think we can paint the boom box. So this has been drying for about a couple of hours. I feel pretty confident I could take the paint cans off. Because I know it says it sets in like 4 minutes and it cures in four, so whatever. Yeah, that's good. So you can see we just glued some washers to it and used those to really make our bond instead of just the glue itself. Let's look at the front here. So we got a little that came out of the front. So let's see if we can get rid of that, maybe sand that down, or there we go. That's fine. So I think the edge here will all be covered up by the overlay, so you won't really see any of the edge. I do want to get some toothpicks and poke holes, make sure all the holes are clear. Yeah, I think I should do that. Let me get some toothpicks. Okay, I'm just going to come in here because all these little holes are just kind of gunked up with sanding residue and stuff like that. And I just want to clear all these out before we paint. I think it's a good idea. And we might have to do this after we paint too, if the paint fills the holes up. Now some of these I can't knock out because we've got that Bondo stuff, that weld. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna keep going here, knocking all these holes out. That one can't. All right, be right back. Okay, I knocked all the holes out with the toothpicks and, excuse me, we're ready to paint this thing. And we're gonna use the Universal Satin Paint and Primer 1 black. Now, the reason I am painting this black and not white is because these speaker grills are exposed and they need to be black. And it was originally all black, as you can see. So we're gonna paint it black again. So let's come over here and I'm gonna paint the back first. I almost always paint the backs of these things first. Simply because if you turn it over and the thing sticks to the cardboard, I don't mind if the back sticks, because that's the part you're not gonna see. So, all right, let's come in here and hit it with a coat. And, boy, I can't believe how long this took, honestly. This took forever. This actually was a lot of work. Oh man, I'm gonna run out of paint, I can tell already. You know, I was at the hardware store and I thought about buying more black paint and I'm like, I think I got enough. I was wrong. I'm gonna have to go back there, I think. We'll see. All right, so that's gonna be the first coat. And then I'll come back and do a second coat and then paint the other side. And, all right, let's let that dry. All right, guys, you know what? That's gonna do it for this video because I'm out of time, and I'm not gonna be able to put the overlay on the control panel and on the boombox tonight because I need the paint to dry overnight. At least, I'd like it to dry for 1 to 2 days before we put the overlay on, especially at least one day. And so we're not gonna be able to put it on here because it's Sunday night now, and I gotta stop. And I'm gonna let this stuff dry. I'm gonna bring it into the house after it dries to the touch, because after about an hour, you can handle this. So after about an hour, I'm gonna bring it in the house, I'm gonna let it dry in the house, and then we'll come back in another video and we'll put the overlay on and the boombox overlay. So, you know, this was actually a lot more work than I thought it was going to be. I thought I was gonna be able to knock this out like really quick, and it turned out to be pretty involved because, well, for one, we had to deal with the metal that was broken on that, and it took forever to get the glue and the paint off of that thing and just getting it nice and presentable. So yeah, it was a lot of work. So anyway, we'll let it dry and then we'll come back in another video and we'll put the overlays on, but that's gonna do it for this video. So why don't we go back down to the basement? All right, guys, there you have it. That was part number 2 of the 720 restoration. And yeah, I know, we didn't finish. But you know what? I cannot put that overlay on until that paint is completely dry. We just can't do that today. So that's going to do it for Sunday. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. That was actually a lot of work, I have to say. more work than I thought. That took me a while to get that done. It took me all weekend, and it wasn't that fun, to be honest. We had to do all that stuff, but that was not fun. That was a lot of work. So we need a drink, damn it. We're gonna have one of my favorite drinks. It's probably really bad for me, and I know, but I really like Rockstar, Diet Rockstar, and vodka. And I know that I should not be drinking these energy drinks. And I probably have too many of them, but It's a damn good drink. So cheers, guys. That's wonderful. Oh man, I needed that. Honestly, that was so much work. I cannot tell you what a pain in the ass that metal, those metal parts were. The layers of paint, like someone painted the boombox silver or something. I'm not sure what's going on there, but it was an absolute disaster. And I went through an entire can of that stripper. I went through an entire can of the goof off, and it was just a sticky mess. And there was silver paint, like someone painted silver paint all over that thing. And that paint was like all over my hands, and everything I was touching was like silver. It was a mess. So we're gonna let the paint dry, and then I'm gonna go back out there in a little bit and paint the other side of the boombox black, and we'll let that dry overnight. I'm gonna bring it in the house, and I think we'll have those pieces drying for a day or two, and then we'll do the next video. We'll put the overlays on, and then there's probably gonna be another video for 720 after that, because we need to address the joystick. So that's kind of the plan here. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. You know, it was just all necessary work. We had to do that stuff. Wasn't fun, wasn't exciting, but it was all necessary. And yeah, we had some missteps with trying to weld that speaker on there with that JB weld type stuff. But using those washers really helped. So anyway, yeah, that's it for this video. I do want to thank you guys for subscribing to my little channel. I release new videos on Sundays and sometimes in between, trying to do two videos a week here. And by the way, we are approaching 14,000 subscribers. Really? I never thought in a million years that I would hit 14,000. And you know what? Honestly, 20,000 is around the corner, and I'm excited about that, because if we can get to 20,000 subscribers, that would be awesome. So tell your friends, guys. If you like this channel, tell people. Share, like, hit the thumbs up button. I don't know how it works, but I think if you like it, it shows up on your Google Plus page or something like that. So make sure you like, make sure you share, tell people, do whatever you gotta do. Get the word out. Let's grow John's Arcade to 20,000 subscribers. And of course, if you've made it to the end of the video and you've never subscribed, hang on a second. Oh, that is so good. It really is. And I like this Rockstar, this zero carb. It's kind of a, I don't know if it's like fruit punch or something. It's sweet. But it's really good with vodka. It's excellent with vodka. But I've been reading and hearing a lot of bad stuff about these energy drinks. And I know that I should not be drinking them. And I know you guys are going to make comments saying, John, don't drink that stuff. Because I saw some article about like how the FDA is not regulating this at all, and they're putting all kinds of crap in here. But the thing is, it's like, I like the flavor. I don't know if I'm addicted to the caffeine or what, but I actually enjoy the flavor, and there's nothing else that tastes like this. I don't know, it's good. So anyway, what was I saying? Yes, if you've made it to the end of the video and you've never subscribed, go ahead and click subscribe. Because that way you can keep up with these videos. Because if you're like me and you like these games, you're going to want to watch these videos, because we do all kinds of stuff, not just this restore stuff. We do arcade reviews. I visit my friends' arcades and we do reviews of their arcades. We travel around and go to like commercial arcades. We went to Hong Kong. We went to Boise. We went to Cedar Point. We've been everywhere, and there's going to be more road trips actually coming up. And then we also do game reviews. So if you want to keep up with all this stuff, be sure to subscribe. And then yes, we are going to be going to Chicago to visit Greg from Arcade Impossible. That's coming up soon. In the next week or two here, we're going to be with Greg filming in the Chicagoland area. I think we're going to be going to Galloping Ghosts, maybe GameWorks. We might do a Craigslist pickup. We're going to definitely go to Greg's house and see his arcade. So look forward to that. And if you've never watched Arcade Impossible, you have to. Greg does such a great job with his videos. So go on YouTube and search for Arcade Impossible. You have to watch his videos. He does such a great job. And then what else? Well, I got two podcasts. One is called Video Game Outsiders. The other is called Arcade Outsiders. Both of those podcasts I do live on Tuesdays starting at 9 p.m. Eastern at allgames.com. So if you want to listen live, go to allgames.com on Tuesdays, 9 p.m. Eastern, and press play. And our voices will start coming out of your computer speakers. And you can also chat, too. There's a chat button. You can chat. And we're watching the chat the whole time. It's actually very interactive. So anyway, allgames.com, Tuesdays, 9 p.m. Eastern. Video Game Outsiders is first, and then at 11 p.m. Eastern is Arcade Outsiders. And of course, if you can't make it live, don't worry. Go to iTunes or Stitcher and do a search for Video Game Outsiders or Arcade Outsiders. And subscribe to both of those podcasts, iTunes and Stitcher. And then what else? Well, I have a band called The Killscreens. And you guys saw kind of a little... Did you guys like that, by the way, recording the music? I've always wanted to do that because... I really love Pro Tools, and I love recording music down here. I do. It's a big part of this basement. And I know that you guys have told me many times, hey, John, you should just get rid of that area and put some games in there. You guys don't understand. That area over there is used, like, a lot. First of all, I record my podcasts over there. I record my music over there. And that's all, those are all big parts of my life. And the music is a gigantic part of my life. You know, my buddy Matt McCarthy comes here at least once a week. And we're recording music constantly over there. We recorded pretty much the entire Killscreen CD right over there, just like we did in the video. Of course, we spent a lot more time on recording. You know, we did that song today. In real time, it took about, 12 minutes to do that song? And but anyway, if you guys want to check out my band, there's a couple ways to do it. You can go to SoundCloud, and you could download some songs for free. We actually put, like, scratch songs and ideas on there. So if you go to soundcloud.com/thekillscreens, we've got all kinds of songs on there you can download for free. We have some of the album releases on there that you can stream for free. And we're always putting stuff on there. In fact, the song that we did today in the video, I will put on SoundCloud. So if you guys want to download that song that we recorded in this video, you guys can go to soundcloud.com/thekillscreens. I'll also put a link in the show notes. And then also, we have a commercial CD that we released that is on iTunes. It's on Amazon. You can buy it. The album is called Science Fiction Movie. It's The Killscreens Science Fiction Movie. It's like $9 on Amazon, I think 10 on iTunes. Go there and purchase a CD. And then also, if you're a Spotify member, you can stream it for free on Spotify. So just go to Spotify and search for The Killscreens Science Fiction Movie. So anyway, I think that's going to do it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And again, thanks for subscribing. Thanks for helping this channel grow to almost 14,000 subscribers. And thanks for all the comments and everything. It actually means a lot. So, all right, guys, that's going to do it. We'll see you next time. Later, and bye.